we need to jump in today, because if we don't, we will lose. We will lose our future, we will lose our democracies. By February, I'll have been a journalist for 38 years, and I have never lived through anything like what we're living through now. Journalists are being attacked on all sides because everyone wants you to say what they want you to say. It isn't about taking a side, it's about giving the facts. It's about giving integrity, giving information with standards and ethics. So this is the reason why we're here. The first contact of AI was in largely for all of us on our cell phones, on social media, right? The design of the systems of social media prioritizes the spread of lies laced with anger and hate. If you're a journalist, you're handcuffed because you're not gonna lie. You'll be legally liable, unlike the platforms that are spreading the lies. And you're not gonna want to incite. This is what we're seeing right now. Today, we're only beginning to imagine what the world can become. And you're seeing some of it play out now on social media in terms of the Middle East violence. Once generative AI comes in and creates audio, video, you can overlay pixel by pixel and change everything. So we are in separate realities. Why should lies that are inflammatory, that trigger hate, outrage, why should that get the widest distribution? In the old days, when news organizations were the gatekeepers, we could slow it down and step back. It's impossible to do that today. Let me add three trends that are extremely worrying for news organizations and why we need to work together. This year, from January to June, Meta, or old Facebook, now called Meta, began to choke traffic. The world's largest distributor of news is choking the distribution of news. The second alarming trend is generative AI search. And this is Google's, but in the United States, you know, you can now search for something and generative AI will pull up the snippet so you don't have to click through to the website. If you're a digital news website, that's the second source of traffic that can die once it's fully rolled out. The third source of traffic is direct. And if the two instances, social and search, are choked, we must find alternative ways of surviving. The Charter on AI gives a glimpse of some of the tools we should be using and the way we can think about it. It's gonna be extremely dangerous in 2024 when we walk into so many elections. There are at least 54 countries with crucial elections, and we have no integrity of facts. We have insidious manipulation on the distribution platforms, which means we're far from assured of having integrity of elections. How do we survive now, right? For news, it's existential. And because it's existential for journalism, it is existential for democracy. News organizations need to jump into the policy fray. If we do not stand up for our rights as journalists, we will lose. Here's the thing that will give us hope. We have to rethink how we can work together, because it's gonna be collaboration, collaboration, collaboration. It's not the old world anymore. It's not within the news organization's power to restore trust alone. We must do it together, humanity over machine. I'm gonna say men and women over machine. The journalists in the end must be the ones making the final calls on information that we get.